member of the United Nations, has always joined the rest of the world to mark the International Day of Persons with Disabilities, both at the federal and state levels, through the Federal Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs, Disaster Management and Social Development. Today is intended to promote member states and other disability stakeholders to focus on issues relating to total inclusion of persons with disabilities, raise awareness and awakening the consciousness of all member states towards encouraging and promoting activities that will bring the issue of disability to the fore and celebrate persons with disabilities in both national and international cycles. Same for this year's International Day of Persons with Disabilities is building back better towards a disability inclusive, accessible and sustainable post-COVID-19 world. This day is focused on ensuring that persons with disabilities are equipped and empowered for the COVID-19 world. To commemorate the day, the Ministry has organized the following activities. One, Muslim prayers at the mosque, which has been observed at the FCBA Central Mosque at 11 on 27th of November 2020. Two, Christian prayers at the church, which has also been observed at the St. Anglican Church, First Avenue, Volunca, Abuja, on 29th November 2020. And three, this ministerial briefing. And four, the grand finale on Thursday, 3rd December 2021, symbolic presentation of assistive devices and economic empowerment tools to persons with disabilities will be made. The Therapeutic Sports Club for PWDs and Coalition of Civil Society Organizations for Women and Girls with Disabilities will also be launched. To demonstrate the commitment of government towards protecting the rights and well-being of PWDs, the Executive Secretary and other board members of the National Commission for Persons with Disabilities were appointed by His Excellency President Muhammad Khan in order to fully commence activities in the Commission. The Commission is responsible for the education, health, economic and civil rights of PWDs and promoting the participation of PWDs in leadership. Furthermore, let me assure you that the federal government will continue to be disability sensitive in supporting and providing a conducive environment towards promoting the participation of persons with disabilities and their leadership to enable a fulfilled life with meaningful contributions to societal growth and development. On this note, I wish to appreciate the gentlemen of the press and other stakeholders for being there today. I urge you to please highlight in dignity the issues that affect PWDs and encourage their inclusion in all aspects of our society. We continue to count on you towards achieving our common goal of protecting and including the vulnerable. As we mark this year's International Day of Persons with Disabilities, I wish once again to celebrate our sisters and brothers with special needs and urge us all to avail ourselves of the opportunities presented through the event of this year's celebration. And thank you for your